Inspirational developments there in Gulu City. Now, officials at the Uganda Virus Research Institute say a vaccine for HIV/AIDS could be on the way in a bid to curb the spread of this scourge. Dr. Brenda Okech, who is leading the International AIDS Vaccine Initiative, has expressed profound hope that this trial could bring the world the much-awaited vaccine.
In the World AIDS Vaccine Awareness Day today in Entebbe, HIV/AIDS prevention researchers disclosed the good news of an upcoming vaccine trial in the country. The trials, which are to commence this year, are believed to give the world the much-awaited HIV vaccine.
This HIV Vaccine Awareness Day, and it's especially exciting because IAVI recently released some very good news about a proof of concept for a vaccine that will be able to stimulate humans to produce broadly neutralizing antibodies. As UVR IAVI, we are under preparation to do a study, a phase one study of broadly neutralizing antibodies that have been prepared in the lab. These broadly neutralizing antibodies are supposed to do the work of preventing HIV among people who are HIV negative.
The scientists will employ the antibody stimulus concept that will enable the body's immune system to kill the different types of HIV. A number of people will be selected to participate in the trials. Potential participants will be selected because they are at a high risk of HIV infections.
IAVI has this bigger news. A vaccine that actually stimulates the body to produce its own broadly neutralizing antibodies. They have proved this in a small study. It's a phase one where they had only 48 participants. And indeed, in 97 of the participants who received the active product, they were able to stimulate those B cells to be able to make these broadly neutralizing antibodies. And so this gives us a lot of hope. We know in this fight for HIV vaccines, it's been a long road. We had some promising news in Thailand some years back, and this year we are especially excited to have this as well.
For us as young people, we need to be involved, we need to be engaged in the research, because the things that the researchers are looking at are not for them, they are for us as people in the community, they are for us as young people. And for us to be able to understand and influence the research, we need to know what is happening, what are they looking at, such that when they are done and these tools are approved, we can be able to use them, adopt them for us, and be able to prevent HIV infections. Yes.
This news created excitement among people living with AIDS. Meanwhile, the Uganda Network of AIDS Service Organization, UNASO, today held a health camp on Nachiwogo residence in Entebbe Municipality. The camp was aimed at creating awareness on HIV/AIDS prevention. Many people were tested and counseled on positive living.
Even if I'm HIV positive, I still need a vaccine of HIV. Because there is a general feeling that we are already infected, so the vaccine we shouldn't support. Somebody was telling me, why are you going to support the vaccine activity and yet you already have? And I gave him like three questions, answers. First and foremost, I have children and they are youth. So this vaccine can benefit my family by helping my children. And when the vaccine comes, infections will stop, which means even the cost of treating people will come down. And when the costs come down, that means that money the government will invest into other things.
This story was compiled by Rachel Nachiwala for the news in Entebbe.